Very good evening to all of you. Today in conversation we have Dr. Ashish Kumar. He is a consultant cancer surgeon and currently he is associated with the Brahmananda Hospital. A very warm welcome, Ashish, and it's a privilege to have you here. And all of us at Keshavi Chalanlal are extremely overjoyed that you could, you know, take our time and be with here and talk to us. If you can just tell us in a very brief that what is the specialization that you do?
Myself, I am a consultant cancer surgeon working in Jamshedpur for last 10 years. My basic area of interest is head neck cancer and GI cancer.
Which cancer?
Head and neck cancer.
Okay.
Head and neck cancer. If you look at the Jharkhand scenario, almost 50% of all the cancer cases are head neck cancer, especially oral cavity cancer. So my area of interest is head neck cancer and gastric.
Any particular reason why it is?
Mostly due to the use of tobacco.
Okay.
Because 90% of the oral cancer are because of the tobacco use only.
Right. Okay. So in the current situation, so when we talk about surgeries, so do you handle these patients who come in for surgeries, and if they have maybe a COVID-like symptom, do you handle them any different? How does the procedure go?
See, the basic procedure remains the same, except for the few things we have to take care of. First is when we know the patient is positive, because there are two things. One is the suspected case, we are suspecting, and there is a positive case. We are at present in our hospital, we are not handling any positive case for the surgery. We refer them to the IA center or any COVID hospital. If there is any suspicious case is there and we have to do surgery, so the surgery duration is very important in those cases.
Okay.
And we use protection in form of PPE, that is protection equipment, plus mask and N95 mask and face cover.
So any patient coming in for surgery, what you are saying is, first they have to undergo the COVID testing. If found positive, then they are referred to a high hospital, TMH in this case.
For surgery, TMH is also not offering COVID positive patient surgeries.
Okay.
So that is the thing.
So what happens? So for example, a patient who comes with some kind of
those patients, see, cancer surgery, unless it's a very emergency, we can wait for 14 days and send the patient for quarantine, and after 14 days then we can operate if the patient is asymptomatic.
Okay.
So that is the thing.
Right. What is the biggest change that you've witnessed, the pre-COVID and in the post-COVID, in terms of the inflow of patients, your work environment?
Personally, if you look at my field cancer surgery, there is not much change. The patient flow is almost same. I am operating almost, you can say, one surgery, cancer surgery per day.
Okay.
So the flow is almost same in the cancer surgery. But if you look out at the overall scenario of the patient in the hospital, it has decreased due to fear also, and many people are not coming because they feel ki if there is some symptom of cough or something like that, they can be quarantined or something like that. So the general flow has decreased, but as far as my field is concerned, it's almost the same.
So when we talk about cancer, you know, when anybody talks about cancer, and all of us, you know, are like taken aback. How serious, say for example, a person going through a surgery, what are the chances of recovery? Do cancer patients actually need surgery, or all cancer patients, do they need surgery?
Okay. So basically, cancer treatment varies. There are three modes of treatment: surgery, radiation, and chemotherapy. Many patients will require surgery, and depending on the stage of the cancer, the adjuvant treatment will be required, whether that is in form of radiation therapy or chemotherapy. So not all the cancer patients really will require surgery. It's basically solid cancer tumor. You can say in a layman time, it's a solid tumor or liquid tumor. Liquid tumor means, you can say, leukemia or lymphoma. The mode of treatment for them is chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Solid tumor, you can say stomach cancer, oral cancer. These patients need surgery upfront if surgery is possible.
Okay.
And that too in the early stage. And as far as the prognosis, or you can say the life expectancy after the surgery or after the treatment, will depend on the stage of the patient coming. So awareness is very important for the cancer patient, and general awareness is also required.
So I'm sure there are chances of rebounds also for cancer.
Yeah, definitely. Well, the chance of recurrence is there. So the stage is very important. The earlier we treat the patient, the more the chance of recovery is there.
Okay.
And the cost of treatment also comes down. as the stage is very, is in the early stage, the cost of treatment is also less.
So, are the surgeries that you do, are they covered under the Ayushman Yojana that the government has?
It's covering Ayushman Yojana, and our hospital is offering Ayushman Yojana for the cancer patient.
Okay. So, what do you think of the situation that is there currently? Is it hyped? The way we are taking care of all the sanitization and maintaining social distance, and the way the cases are increasing on a daily basis. So, what, according to a medico like you, what do you think of the situation, and what will it be 6 months down the line, or 3 months down the line?
See, first and foremost, we have to accept this thing. This coronavirus has entered into our system,
Okay. And
we have to live with it. Now we have to how to avoid it. The most important factor is social distancing and personal protection, that is use of mask. That is the most important thing which you have to follow. And other things will come into the play. Almost 80 to 90% are asymptomatic. That means they are developing immunity. And only 5 to 10% require hospitalization. And that too, if you see the death rate is almost 2%. So it's not, you can say it's high, but if you see the number of patients being infected because of high infectivity, and because of the media also, this is being created as a very big disease.
Right.
And it's a pandemic since all the countries are involved. So this is the reason why I think it's more hype and more media are giving news.
More media is giving it, it's giving it a lot of focus.
Yeah.
So you said you've been in Jamshedpur for like 10 years now.
Yes.
So where were you before that?
Before that, I did my MBA from Calcutta. Before that, I was in Calcutta, then in Patna.
What inspired? Do you have a doctor's family?
No.
So what inspired you to become a doctor?
I never wanted to become a doctor.
Then how come?
Seriously, I always wanted to become a
doctor. You didn't want to become a doctor, but you land up becoming a doctor, that too in a very specialized field.
Now I'm enjoying my field, definitely. But if you ask me personally, I never wanted to become a doctor. I wanted to become an Air Force pilot.
Okay.
So, wanted to go NDA.
So, where did the diversion happen?
My mother, she was never interested in me going to army field.
Okay.
So, that was the main reason.
So, this happened in college or school?
After 12th. I was selected for NDA. But didn't go.
And you met Shalini in college?
No, I met Shalini at college. I was doing my MS in Patna.
Okay.
And she was doing in Lady Arden. So
right.
We met through my sister friend.
What do you think about the placebo effect that we are reading about? You know, that fake medicine, it creates a psychological effect on patients.
Placebo effect, it depends on the what kind of disease you are seeing.
Okay.
It varies from person to person. See, placebo, it's a basically, if you say ki you are giving medicine, it's not a medicine. And patient is thinking it's a medicine. That is the placebo effect. Because that gives a soothing effect, especially in a person who thinks he's diseased. And the doctor thinks, no, there is no as such disease as there. So it can be given, it can be in form of vitamin also, it can be form in any medicine.
Okay.
As such.
So you are saying this is only suitable for very, very few and very mild ailments?
That's it.
Not for something like a cancer?
No, nothing like a cancer.
Okay. And what about all these, we've been seeing a lot of media and we see long khali jiye, ab garam pani pi lijiye. Do you think all that has an effect, maybe not on getting rid of corona, but in increasing immunity? Because what we've lately been hearing is, immunity badhaiye, immunity badhaiye.
Personally, I have no idea about this, but people are saying it's dadi ka nuska.
Dadi ka nuska, correct.
So, usko bol sakte hai, people are using it. So, it's not bad for the health. It can
karna to karna.
That's the thing. It can boost your immunity.
It definitely boosts your immunity. True. So I think we've spoken a lot about the medical field. Now it's time for a little bit of fun. We'll go to the rapid fire round.
Okay.
And I will ask you very few questions, and whatever comes to your mind, you'll have to tell me.
Nothing comes to mind.
No, you have to say something. Actually, something has to come to your mind.
Something.
One film that inspired you the most in life.
Forrest Gump.
Forrest Gump. That's a beautiful movie. Three words that describe you.
Honest, hardworking, disciplined.
Honest, hardworking, and disciplined. One compliment that you receive from your friends and family that you remember. I'm sure you get a lot of compliments.
Honest.
Okay. The other question was, if you weren't a doctor, definitely you would be a fighter pilot, I guess. If you weren't a doctor, what would you be? You'd be a pilot. Not a commercial pilot, but a fighter pilot. Your current celebrity crush? Hollywood, Bollywood, anything?
Deepika Padukone.
Okay. One Hindi film dialogue that you can think of right now?
Kitni aadmi.
See, everybody is. I think you're the third person to say this. Your real life role model?
My father.
Why? What did he do?
He's a music engineer.
He's still working or is he retired?
Retired.
Retired. Okay. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the least and 10 being the highest, how cool are you?
Taking some time.
Very cool. Yeah, actually, yeah, you are cool. One thing which you think that you can never do. Anything.
Which I can never do.
You can never do. कुछ भी अरे यार ये cycling नहीं होना ये
हाँ वो मैं समझ गया मतलब it's running
running you can never do running
but I think
you can't do long distance you mean
long distance
but you do cycle I've seen you cycling a lot in Jubilee Park and all that and the last one your favorite day of the week
it's Saturday
why
because next day is Sunday so you get
because you're excited for the holiday Chalo, great. I think that was a lovely rapid fire round and we had some lovely answers from you, Ashish. And it was a pleasure having you here and wishing you a very, very happy Doctor's Day in advance.
Thank you. Thank you for calling me. It's an honor to come here.
Thank you. Thank you very much.